Rising Tide Swing Dance Studio. We're here in our Franklin, Massachusetts home studio to go over our recap from last Saturday's lesson.
Tonight's class was all about dancing to the music, especially to songs that we're not familiar with. So we picked two songs that pretty much no one had heard. And then for leaders, we gave you three different options for how to hit the music. We gave you one that was kind of a low-key, I heard the music, but I'm not going to make a big deal out of it. One that was a little more of a big deal, and then one was our big money payout.
For our followers, we talked about ways to hit the music with musical accents and styling regardless of our leader's movement. So these are stylings that we can choose if our leader is hitting with a musical pattern or not. These stylings had three different models. One was an isolation of a body part, two was an elevation of the whole body or singular body part, and three was a speed change. And I'll introduce those and exemplify those in the patterns that we dance together.
Yep. We try to keep the sequences relatively similar to each other. We start out with our starter step, triple step, triple step. Here we do a whip from closed position, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, and eight, catching the second hand on the way out. Then we do a hustle check. So we wrap our followers in and open up on five, six, seven, and eight.
For followers, I'm looking at both an isolation of a body part, the knee, and an elevation of that body part into either coupe or passe. If we wanted to do speed change here, we could do a drag of the foot into coupe.
From there, we do another whip. Five, six, seven, and eight, followed by a double outside turn. Three and four, hitting on five, holding six, seven, eight.
Here we talked about doing a speed change for the followers of hitting on the five and melting into the six, seven, and eight to allow for the contrast of the hit into a melt. We also talked about the opportunity for those hearing a staccato part of the music to do shoulder isolations or ribcage isolations into that musical moment.
Leaders, we're not doing a lot here in this moment. If you want, you can add some footwork or some body movement, but as a baseline, we're just hitting and holding and letting the moment resonate. From there, we do one more whip, three and four, five, six, seven, and eight, and we do our inside turn into a basic dip.
Now followers, this is already an elevation change for us. We're going to see our right leg is kickstanded, so we've got our own weight here for the most part. However, if we want to hit from the 8 to the 1 with an even more dramatic speed change after this elevation change, what we're going to do is we're going to use our right leg, particularly the right ball of foot, and our leg to push up into the moment on the 1. We can accentuate that with a little bit of choreography if we'd like to.
Leaders, we're not leading that. So, dancing that to the first song. Starter step, close whip, hustle checks, whip, double outside turn, six, seven, eight, whip. Into the dip. That was the first song. For the second song, we're just going to repeat that piece with the whip and the hustle check. So we're going to do that part twice. Another hustle check here.
Thank you so much for joining us at our home studio. I hope you had a good time, and thank you so much. us who came out to Longfellow on Saturday. I'm Desiree, this is Matt, and we're the Rising Tide Swimming Expedition.